What better way to conclude the first core of Moriarty the Patriot than by having Mycroft Holmes pop up as he attempts to figure out what's going on with royalty and something trying to be stolen, probably has been stolen? There is no better way than to conclude the first arc than doing just that as we wait for spring for the next 13 episodes. For those who don't know, there will be more Moriarty the Patriot. It was always confirmed to be 24 episodes total. But there was going to be a split core, meaning we'd have to wait 3 months before we get the next core. Originally, it was looking like it was going to be 12 episodes in 12 episodes, but then it came out that episode 11 would be the end of the first half, which seems a little weird when you look at it before watching this episode, but seeing how this one wraps up, it does feel like the optimal stopping point, so then when we kick into spring of next year, the 13 episode run should provide for some insanity. We already have the mutual respect and almost like frenemy dilemma between William James Moriarty and Sherlock Holmes. They respect each other a hell of a lot, even if both of their partners in crime, one being a brother and one being a friend who's a little reluctant to stick around, even though he does get treated like shit from time to time, both are probably wondering, what's the other one got in mind? I think by having the whole Mycroft situation, by having this like a bigger conspiracy going on, to then also just having the will they, won't they understand who they are, it's gonna provide for some insanity, to say the least. Had there never been a confirmation of a split core, if they would have cut the Mycroft situation, it would have been the perfect stopping point. You would have been satisfied with what you've seen, and while you would have wanted more, it would have been a decent stopping point. So by having it already be confirmed for another 13 episodes, it brings a giant grin to your face, because the twisting and turning of someone like Moriarty and Sherlock Holmes, both of which are very overused characters, but very rarely done so with grace, that can kind of go in line with the classic Holmes books. To have something feel like they both were twisted in a way that feels honorable to what came before, but also doing something different, it really does bring a giant grin to your face. I mean, this episode, honestly, one of the most shocking elements was the fact that James had nothing to do with this. Liam had nothing to do with this, which I love the pet name that Sherlock gives him in this episode, showing how close they are, but also we as the viewer know how distant they truly are. But it's interesting because both of which respect the other, both of which have said that they respect and think the other is pretty impressive. I mean, William says it at the end of the episode, Sherlock has said it multiple times throughout the episodes. So to have something like this where he literally had nothing to do with it was actually kind of fun watching both of them act like the detective for once, where you get to see them piece together the breadcrumbs. There was a lot of clues, there was a lot of foreshadowing, nothing about the solving of the case came from left field, as if they magically figured this out and they pulled things from thin air. They smelled something that the viewer can't smell. They noticed something that the viewer can't notice. Everything about the formula of solving why this jeweler got killed, why it was so sloppy, why it was done on a moving train where the killer couldn't get away. Why would the killer not dispose of his clothing? What is going on here? And they made it feel pretty solid. To be honest, when they first introduced one of the workers who's handing Moriarty the kind of like information on the logs, who's all on the train, as soon as I saw the gloves, I was like, that kid right there is going to be the killer. It just felt like that's what they're doing. It's anime. The most obvious thing is always going to be the killer, because most anime don't have a good detective formula going for it. So the reveal that it wasn't necessarily this person, but it was going to be one of the workers, because, well, for one, the boots match up to a certain place that they come from, so the footprints, the fact that they didn't, you know, dispose of the clothes, why would they run to the washroom when they could easily just toss away everything? There'd be no proof to say so, unless they couldn't toss away the clothing. So to line them all up, and then to see not this kid who I thought was going to be the killer, I thought what was going to happen was, you know, the first two people who walked up weren't going to be that. And then to see the person with blood on his hands, I was like, this seems too easy. There's no way that Sherlock got it right, especially considering that William was so determined to solve this beforehand. So when the reveal came that there was blood on the glasses after basically him throwing it in Sherlock's face that there's no proof, you know, I cut my hands, it looks pretty believable, I was thinking to myself, I was a little disappointed. And quickly my disappointment went away, don't get me wrong, but while watching, when William pulls up the blood on the glasses, it felt convenient. It felt like while he probably had something to do with this, how could he know for sure until the moment of questioning? And to actually see not only just him win this situation by using an unconventional and unlawful way of planting blood on every single one of the workers in different locations, so that when the real traitor was revealed, you know, the real person behind this killing was revealed, he could point out something that only he would notice. And it's something that's so slithery, it's something that's so unlawful, but it shows you the difference of someone like Sherlock Holmes, who would have caught this guy, who would have been able to prove his guilt through a trial. There's no doubt about that. William himself admits to that fact. But the difference between William and Sherlock is that Sherlock will do things by the law, by the books. He will get the job done, but it will take him a long time, and sometimes, because he's taking the right approach by moral standards, those people will get away scot-free. Someone like that guy could have easily just booked it, could have went to a different city, a different country, and never been seen again. But William takes that extra step to plant the evidence to make sure that once he knows for sure, the law or not, he'll get the job done. And it shows you how similar yet different these two characters are. I honestly can't remember ever feeling this much wonder experiencing a Sherlock Holmes story than having Moriarty the Patriot in anime form. The gothic horror aesthetic, when it gets into its more sinister moments, is completely what you want to see, but just the general presentation and the old England feel, it feels so perfect for what it tries to be. And the most important thing for this show was to nail a different persona for someone like Moriarty. The fact that they went a step above to establish Sherlock Holmes as someone equally as different yet distinguishable from things we've seen before. This show is honestly, I would say, a masterpiece. I mean, some people may want to be like, whoa, masterpiece, that's a strong word. Why would this show be a masterpiece? But the level of detail put into its characters, put into the crimes, while some in the intro were a little convenient with how characters solved it, you can't deny the moral dilemma of does the end justify the means, and how they twisted it to not just feel like something that came before. So many times you have shows that try to make its characters seem morally ambiguous, and you don't know is what they're doing actually going to justify the end result. But then when you conclude episode 11, you look at both Moriarty and Sherlock, both of which believe in what they're doing, solving crime or trying to change the world. But at the end of the day, both of them have come to a point where they just want something to challenge their intellect, and both of which satisfy that for the other. Even if someone like Sherlock can't prove that Moriarty is actually behind all these other killings, they respect each other's challenge, and at this point, I would honestly firmly believe William is more interested in challenging Sherlock than he is about changing the world, as Sherlock is more about challenging this strange opponent that he doesn't know, but probably suspects it could be his new pal Liam. And the fact that they're just not even mad at the other, but just respect the other, that's amazing to me. The show has been a remarkable ride, and you know damn well I'll be reviewing The Second Core when it comes out in spring. It's not the most popular show that people have been watching, but I think for those of us who have been watching it, we've been loving the ride, and for right reasons. Let me know your thoughts and feelings on the first core of Moriarty the Patriot, your favorite moment, and where you think it might go in The Second Core in spring of next year. If you enjoyed the video, of course, leave a like, share your support, and hit that subscribe button if you happy new around here. So until next time, everyone, please take care and have a good one.